Time for the Hollywood Hotline. May I have your name and age?
Karen Shumway, 16.
Karen, on the hotline, we're calling Toronto, Canada. We have the Irish-born Rovers here, Will Millar, on the line. Is that you, Will? And if so, how are you? Hello?
Not so bad, Dick. How's yourself?
Very fine, thank you. We've got two, three questions, Will. Here is question number one.
Will, how long has the group been recording?
Well, the Unicorn was our second album. We've been recording for a year. The first album we had was called The First of the Irish Rovers. We thought it would probably be the last, but we were very happy to put out The Unicorn and happier still to have it make such a good success.
Question number two, Will.
How did you happen to pick this particular number?
Well, Shel Silverstein writes some of the greatest songs for children that I have ever heard, and The Unicorn, I used to sing it to children, and it got a great response with the children, but we found out, strangely enough, that in even the most hardened nightclub audiences, it would be our most requested song, so we decided that would be the song to release. I think it has an international appeal. No matter what age you are, the story of The Unicorn will appeal to you.
All right, Karen, last question coming up for Will.
Do you plan to tour the United States soon?
Oh, yes, definitely. We'll be going on a tour very shortly, all right across the United States. I can't say exactly where and when, but it'll be all the major cities.
Will, I can't tell you how joyful it was to have you with us. We all enjoyed talking with you and love your Irish brogue there. Good luck with the record, and when you're in town, please drop by, will you?
Well, Dick, can I give you a special little Irish blessing from the Rovers to all your listening audience and to yourself?
Please do, me boy.
These are the words my grandfather gave me when I left home, and I'll just pass them on to everybody. May the wind always blow in your back, may your house be free from rent. May your days be as long as the beard on Paddy McGinty's goat. When you're 135, may you die in Ireland. And may you be half an hour in heaven before the devil knows you're dead. Good luck.
Will, thank you very much. The Irish Rovers, here we go. Thank you.
A long time ago when the earth was green, there was more kinds of animals than you'd ever seen. They'd run around free when the earth was being born, but the loveliest of them all was the unicorn. There was green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpy backcamas and some chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but sure as you're born, the loveliest of all was the unicorn. God seen some sinning, and it gave him pain. And he says, stand back, I'm going to make it rain. He says, hey, brother Noah, I'll tell you what to do. Build me a floating zoo, and take some of them green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpty-backed camas and some chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but sure as you're born, don't you forget my unicorn. Old Noah was there to answer the call. He finished up making the ark just as the rain started falling. He marched in the animals two by two, and he called out as they went through, hey Lord, I got you green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpty-backed camels and some chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but Lord, I'm so forlorn, I just can't see no unicorn. Then Noah looked out through the driving rain. Them unicorns were hiding, playing silly games, kicking and splashing while the rain was pouring. Oh, them silly unicorns. It was green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpty-backed camels and some chimpanzees. Noah cried, close the door, cause the rain is pouring, and we just can't wait for no unicorn. The ark started moving, it drifted with the tide. Them unicorns looked up from the rocks and they cried, and the waters came down and sort of floated them away. And that's why you never seen a unicorn till this very day. You'll see green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpty bagcamas and some chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but sure as you're born, you're never gonna see no unicorn.
You know, I get you all know the famous Hook Dancers, the Louis Dupron group. This reminds me of Captain Kangaroo time today. You know, that dance they were doing, do you all know what it, of course, you know, it's a bunny hop. How old were any of you in 1953? You were 4 years old, 2 years old? That was the old bandstand people, yeah, who've got kids now. In any case, we thank the Irish Rovers. Hold on, we'll be right back with Bandstand in just a moment.